In the heart of summer, when the air is thick with heat, a chorus begins to rise. A sound so ancient and so endearing, it has echoed through the ages. This is the song of the cicadas, a mysterious creature that spends the majority of their lives underneath our feet, only to emerge in spectacular fashion. Cicadas are not just insects. They are biological marvels wrapped in an exoskeleton, living on a timeline that defies human understanding. Their life cycle, which can span over a decade, accumulates in a crescendo of sound and activity that marks one of nature's most remarkable events. But what drives these creatures to such a meticulously timed emergence? And why do they spend so much of their lives underground? The tale of the cicada starts with the female using her sharp ovipositor to carve a niche in a tree branch. There she lays hundreds of eggs. This chosen spot offers the future offspring a sap buffet, their main food. When their eggs hatch, tiny nymphs no bigger than a grain of rice drop from the tree, leaving the sunny world above. They burrow into the ground where they'll spend most of their lives. In the soil darkness, these nymphs tap into tree and plant roots, sucking sap to nourish themselves. They lead patient lives, slowly growing, molting, and developing. At each stage, they shed their exoskeleton, leaving behind ghostly shells of their past selves as they evolve. Despite the subterranean existence, they're not alone. Nymphs communicate via vibrations in the soil, a silent symphony echoing underground. They form a community, living and growing together in the deep, dark earth. When the time is right, something miraculous happens. The nymphs all undergo a synchronized metamorphosis, emerging from the ground as adults, ready to fulfill their destiny. And this is where the real magic of cicadas begins. After crawling out of the soil and shedding their final exoskeleton, adult cicadas reveal themselves in all their glory. Their vibrant colors and intricate patterns make them a sight to behold. But it's their sound that truly sets them apart from any other insect. Male cicadas have specialized organs called timbals, which they use to create that iconic buzzing sound we associate with these creatures. By flexing and releasing the muscles attached to the timbal, they can produce a series of clicks that combine to create their signature call. This loud, persistent sound can reach up to 100 decibels, making it one of the loudest produced by any insect. But why do cicadas produce such a loud chorus? It all goes back to their purpose in life, reproduction. The males use their calls to attract females for mating. The louder they are, the more likely they are to be noticed. But not all cicadas produce the same sound. Each species has its own unique call, specific to their region and time of emergence. This helps prevent confusion and competition between different cicada species. Once mating is complete, the females use their ovipositor to deposit their eggs into tree branches, starting the cycle again. And so the cycle of life for these insects continues, as it has for millions of years. In the world of cicadas, diversity thrives with over 3,000 recognized species worldwide. Each cicada species is uniquely adapted to its environment and lifestyle. Annual cicadas, which emerge every year, have a life cycle that lasts 2 to 5 years. Although this is less noticeable, since some members of their population emerge every summer. These cicadas usually have a greenish color and are larger than their periodical counterparts. They sing during the hottest parts of summer, and their songs become a familiar backdrop to those warm months. On the other hand, Periodical cicadas have a much more extended developmental phase, spending either 13 or 17 years underground. This long gestation period is one of nature's most curious survival strategies. It allows them to avoid predation by emerging in overwhelming numbers, a phenomenon known as predator satiation. The periodical cicadas are generally smaller, having striking black bodies with red eyes, and their mass emergence is a much anticipated event due to its rarity. But how do they survive such an extended period underground? It all comes down to survival strategies and adaptation. These cicadas have evolved to have a longer lifespan and slower metabolism, allowing them to conserve energy and survive for such extended periods without feeding. They also have a hardy exoskeleton, which can withstand the pressure of living underground for years, ensuring their survival until it's time to emerge once again. The emergence of cicadas, particularly the vast numbers seen with periodical varieties, has a profound impact on the ecosystems they inhabit. This phenomenon provides a significant source of nutrients to a wide variety of predators. Birds, small mammals, fish, and even other insects partake in this bounty, experiencing a surge in their populations due to the abundance of food. But the cicada's influence extends beyond a mere food source. Their mass emergence and subsequent death contribute organic matter to the soil, greatly enhancing its fertility. This influx of nutrients supports plant growth, leading to healthier and more robust forests and fields. In addition, the action of millions of cicadas burrowing and emerging from the ground naturally aerates the soil, improving its structure and water absorption capacity. Thus, the life cycle of cicadas, while seemingly isolated, plays a critical role in nurturing the environment, showcasing the interconnectedness of nature's cycles. The triggers for cicada emergence, especially the periodical types, remain a captivating mystery of nature. These triggers are finely tuned responses to a mix of environmental factors and internal clocks. The main cue for cicadas to emerge is soil temperature. Remarkably, cicadas underground can detect subtle temperature changes at a depth of about 8 inches. When the soil hits around 64 degrees Fahrenheit or 18 degrees Celsius, the magic begins. This temperature acts as an alarm clock, stirring the nymphs from their long slumber and urging them to the surface. Additionally, cicada emergence timing may be influenced by the nutritional value of the tree sap they feed on, which varies throughout the year. This dietary change signals the time to emerge and start their adult phase. Other factors such as humidity, light levels, and even the vibrations of other cicadas can also play a role in synchronizing emergence. As fascinating as these triggers may be, they are not foolproof. Climate change and environmental disruptions can cause variations in soil temperature and nutrient availability, throwing off the cycles of cicadas. In some cases, this has led to periodical cicadas emerging earlier than expected, resulting in lower populations and potential concerns for their survival. That is why understanding the natural triggers and cycles of these insects is crucial for preserving their existence. As we continue to study and learn more about cicadas, their life cycles, and their impact on the environment, we are continually amazed by these remarkable creatures. From their unique songs and mating rituals, to their extended periods underground and mass emergences, cicadas offer a glimpse into the intricate workings of nature. They remind us that even in our busy modern world, there are still mysteries and wonders to behold, and that we are just a small piece in the grand tapestry of life on Earth. Thank you for joining us on this journey into the insane biology of cicadas. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. Until next time, keep exploring.